utility crews raced Wednesday to restore power to nearly 3.4 million customers around the U.S. who were still without electricity or heat in the aftermath of a deadly winter storm, and another blast of ice and snow threatened to sow more chaos. The latest storm front was expected to bring more hardship, especially to states that are unaccustomed to such frigid weather, parts of Texas, Arkansas, and the lower Mississippi Valley. There's really no let up to some of the misery people are feeling across that area, said Bob Orovic, lead forecaster with the U.S. National Weather Service, referring to Texas. The system was forecast to move into the northeast on Thursday. More than 100 million people live in areas covered by some type of winter weather warning, watch, or advisory, the Weather Service said. At least 30 people have died in the extreme weather this week, some while struggling to find warmth inside their homes. In the Houston area, one family succumbed to carbon monoxide poisoning from car exhaust in their garage. Another perished as they used a fireplace to keep warm. Record low temperatures were reported in city after city. Scientists say the polar vortex, a weather pattern that usually keeps to the Arctic, is increasingly spilling into lower latitudes and staying there longer, and global warming is partly responsible.